lot of information. I've got a lot of little spreadsheets, and, you know, they're probably not going to mean much to you guys because I'm not really good about labels, but I know what it's doing, so I can look at it and help them. So, again, we want to make sure that people educate. Yeah, it always is. It is a shocker when you open it up, kind of like, you know, if you're not in the budget bill on the gas side, you know, you get your gas bill in January, it's always a shocker too, you know, after that furnace has been running. So, unfortunately, I think just a storm, perfect storm kind of happened in July where we had that really hot week. And it just turned everybody's house into a hot box, and that really stressed everything. And it's kind of interesting, you know, I kind of wrote a little thing for the newspaper, we'll see if it goes in or how it comes across. But, you know, a big part of that is temperature gap. You know what I mean? So a lot of people might say, well, I have my house at 75 in June, you know, but the average temperature is only here. And so I made sure in July I even bumped it up to 77 or 78. Well, the temperature was this. So, you know, yeah, you bumped it up, but the gap got bigger, you know? And so I think that's really, you know, and again, it's something we think about, I think about a lot, but for somebody else, they might not think about that a lot. So it's more of a shocker to them when that happens. So those are just kind of some of the things that I've been trying to talk to people about. And obviously, it's something that, you know, we can continue to try to work on and try to get lower. So yeah, I think that's what drove. Some of these people just have a huge amount, but I would tell them to look at their whole year maybe and compare it to the first 6 or 7 months of last year. That also brings a little bit different perspective. So, because, you know, it's kind of funny, kind of like we talked, you know, June was really, really good. And so we're like, oh, we know it's going to make July look that much more outrageous, you know, and it kind of did. The other thing that happened in July too is, just from the background, it's really hard to explain to people, but basically we're part of the Southwest Power Pool. And so in July, which after all this work and our PCA lower, did all this crazy stuff, we took a little bit of a hit in July because somebody, I can't remember which massive company, and it's kind of stock market, basically the easiest way to put it, they did a call instead of a put. You know what I mean? They did a long instead of a short, and it was purely an accounting function, but of course it screwed up a whole lot. So that pushed that PCA higher than it should have been. Of course, it was in the highest usage month. So it made everybody's bill just that much more expensive, if you will. So what they're I kind of knew what the number was. Sure, if I had gone and just maybe punched it in and fixed it and it would have compressed that a little bit, yeah. But unfortunately, what they're going to do, what they've done to correct it is every day in August, you know, the matching day now in August, they do, you know, they fix it back. Does that make sense? So it's going to come back through in the preceding months. So that's the nightmare with it. You know, okay, you do it here, but then I have no way of knowing how exactly do I add back or how do I do, you know what I mean? So you just kind of do, okay, we're not talking, you know, it might affect the bill, you know, like my bill, $10 or $15, you know, but that is real money, but that's going to come back. But of course, we're not going to feel that. But what we're going to see it as really in that PCA. So that PCA was kind of trending to be about, you know, maybe a 5% for, you know, let's say an average user using 1,000 kilowatts, maybe a 5%. When it kind of squeezed up to maybe 3.5 this month because of that, well, I think it's going to trend back down, you know, like it was before. So that just piled onto it, but that's really technical and really hard to explain. You know, you're talking, I mean, this is something that kind of like in June of last year when they had that big explosion at Jeffrey Energy Center. Remember, we had that huge spike in our June bills? Kind of same thing. It's so out of our control that just things happen. This, thankfully, is actually going to wash back out. That one did. That one we almost had to eat because it was really high, but it affected quite a lot of Kansas.
With that article that you said was in the paper, is that going to be a letter to the editor?
That's how I did it. Yes, that's what Sharon asked me to do. It's so hard to write this stuff. I mean, it's really hard. So I hope it comes across okay. You know what I mean? Like what we're trying to do, where it's going. It's kind of in the same vein as like the Facebook post, but it'd be a lot easier if I just invite everybody in and say, hey, let's just talk about it. Because it's really easy to talk about and kind of show and guide through. It's really hard to write about.
Everything that I heard on the Facebook thing was very positive.
Yeah. 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 And honestly, a lot of it, again, you got to think about it. They're not thinking, I didn't even think about it. So yeah, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say it that badly. Like, no, it's fine. You know what I mean? Like, a lot of people are just, again, you open a bill, like, $400. You know what I mean? And, you know, I'm not really that way. I understand some people are like, wow, this stinks. My $400 bill, I get it. You know what I mean? Like, it is painful. So
just asking why.
Well, exactly. And that's what a lot of it is, you know. And some of them, you know, some of them try a little bit of exaggeration, but look, it's not exactly as dire as it is, but it's still a big deal. And like I was telling somebody, it's still motivating for me and I think for us as a council to continue to find ways to deliver those services, you know, cheaper or flatline as best we can. And but kind of on the consumer too, and I'm a consumer too, to look at all those options. I mean, I've got a smart thermostat. It knows when I'm gone, it knows when I'm home, it knows when I'm at your desk, you know, and that makes a big difference too. And I have a couple people even admitted, and it's true, and that makes your heart go out for it more, and it also kind of helps, you know, use Carol's resources, you know, just needs some weatherization, you know, and that's kind of what a few people even mentioned, like, I still got single pane windows in my house, and this, and I think that's what's really killing me, you know, on this thing, and, you know, or, you know, my air conditioner is really old, you know, and obviously that makes, I mean, I replaced my furnace last year, which isn't even the air conditioner part, but I replaced it in the end of July last year, and I can tell it's helped, you know what I mean, like, you know, my July bill wasn't, it was still high, obviously, but it wasn't even as high, my June of 18 bill was higher than my July bill this year, and it was, so, I mean, you know, big part is just obviously, more, you know, replacing a 20-year-old furnace, there's, not everybody can do that, I get that, but that's, there's, yeah, July just, that July bill just stunk. But, sorry, I was kind of
No, that's fine. Yeah. We needed to get that up there because we have
Yeah.
Did you call it Terry?
Yeah. Something I really think about a lot, obviously. It bugs me a lot.
I don't get it on Facebook.
Makes me feel really responsible.
Okay, well, thank you, Jason.
Yeah.
The thing is, if my electric bill goes up $200, where am I going to get those $200? I mean, we understand that. I knew mine was going to go up because it was higher and I didn't want to sweat.
Yeah.
But, I mean, that's what people are dealing with.
Yeah, exactly.
Where's that extra money going to come from that I know, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah, that's kind of what I tried to allude to in the Facebook post and in this, you know, it's obviously an impact, you know, and it's hard to plan for that. You know, I mean, you kind of know it's coming, but it's still a shocker, you know? And yeah, some of those people are even, you know, they're newer homeowners, so it's maybe their first go around with it. You know what I mean? Like, some of those old hats were kind of like, okay, I was going to stink this month, but... absolutely. I think that's just it, and especially since it was set up by a fairly, you know, everybody knows June's usually hot too, but this June, especially compared to last year, was not too bad. You get a swallow. So all of a sudden you get a bill that maybe half again as much or double. That's, yeah, that's a pinch on people for sure.
Okay. So I'm going down here, I'm going to take care of it.
Yeah.
Talk to Jason.
All the bills.
Okay, the next item on the agenda this evening is a closed session pursuant to KSA 75-4319, executive session to discuss personnel matters of non-elected personnel. The regular public meeting will resume at a time set by the council. This will include the governing body and city manager for how long?
10 minutes.
For 10 minutes, I entertain a motion. Motion been made for 10 minutes closed session with the governing body and the city manager, maybe for 10 minutes. Second by Councilman Grabon. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same. Motion carries. We'll adjourn for 10 minutes.
Well, here in the heat.
Oh, that's my brother.